Avid Media Composer provides a method of linking to media directly. Avid uses the term AMA Link, which stands for Avid Media Access. You can use this functionality to link to individual QuickTime movie files or an entire folder of QuickTime files. You can also use this function to link to a volume. A volume refers to the content that is packaged into a folder. A volume can be as simple as a thumb drive with self-contained QuickTime files, or a volume can represent a media card from a camera manufacturer, such as a Panasonic P2 card or a Sony S x S card. Each camera manufacturer has a different way of packaging their content, and it's very important to keep the entire directory structure of a volume intact in order for the Avid to link to it. It's important that you download the current manufacturer's driver for each volume type you plan to use. Fortunately, Avid makes these drivers easy to find by providing direct links to each manufacturer's website. Go to avid.com/AMA. After you've downloaded the appropriate drivers, you're ready to link to the content within a volume. To do this, navigate to the File menu and choose AMA Link. When linking to a volume, choose the root directory of the volume in order to link to the media. And bam, now you're ready to edit. When you link to a volume or a movie file, the clip icons in the bin will have a link next to them. The advantage of linking directly to a volume is that you will have immediate access to the media and you do not have to wait for the files to be imported. Note, in using this method, if the location of the volume changes or it is disconnected, the media will become offline. If that's the case, you will need to link back to the same volume again, and your clips will automatically relink to the media. With all this being said, if your computer already sees a volume before you launch Avid Media Composer, the Avid will automatically link to any volumes connected to your system and place clip links into a new bin. If you would like to change this automated behavior, navigate to the Project window and click on the Settings tab. Double-click on the AMA settings. Under the Bin tab, click Use Active Bin. Then click on the Volume Mounting tab. Uncheck Automatically AMA Link to Volumes. Now, the Avid also provides for a method of linking to self-contained movie files that live outside of a volume. To do this, navigate to the File menu and choose AMA Link. In this example, I'll link to these movie files that are located on my thumb drive. Select the files you want to link to and press the Open button. Now you can see the clip links that reference the location of your movie files on the thumb drive. And finally, if you are linking to movie files that change to a different directory path, you will need to relink them. So, for example, if I disconnect or rename my thumb drive here, the media will go offline. To relink the files, highlight them within a bin and right-click on them. Choose Relink to AMA Files. Within the dialog box, choose one of the files in the list that the Avid is looking for and press the Open button. Then the Avid will automatically relink all the other files as long as they are in the same directory path. Okay, now you have the basics of linking to media.